Happy New Year, everyone. I'm Reverend Vicki Burtson, the pastor of the Homer Congregational United Church of Christ. So glad you could join us for worship on this second Sunday after Christmas. So we have lit the Christ candle, remembering that we are still in the Christmas season. Today is also Communion Sunday, so I hope you've brought some bread or crackers, some juice, or maybe water to the screen with you so that you can join us for communion in just a little bit. I was thinking about this service and thinking about this past season and recognizing that one of the changes that came upon us is that we just haven't been able to sing the way we have in other years. And I know how good for our souls it is to sing, and especially to sing the songs that we love. And so our service today will incorporate many of our favorite Christmas carols, and I hope that from wherever you are, you will just join us and sing with gusto. We begin today with that terrific setting that our choir and Joe Ford gave us. The song is called Let Heaven and Nature Sing. Special thank you to our choir for that terrific piece. And I invite you now, let us pray. Good and gracious God, the psalmists long ago spoke about how we can best praise you by singing new songs, old songs. And so in this time, we ask that you hear our praise, our joy, as we remember words like joy to the world, hark the herald angels sing, and so many more. We offer our praise to you, O God, in the midst of this season when we celebrate the birth of the Christ long ago and even today. It is in the name of the one called Emmanuel, God with us, that we offer our prayer. Amen. And now, kids, Alex is here to offer a children's time.
Happy New Year, kids! It's 2021. Can you believe we're in the first Sunday of this new year? I can't believe it. Were you guys able to stay up all the way until midnight to watch the new year come in at 12? It's really hard for me to stay up that late these days, but I do think it's really fun to throw confetti or make noise or just celebrate with family and friends how exciting it is to be in a new year. I think a lot of people were especially excited about this new year because 2020 had a lot of scary and uncertain moments. We were worried about getting sick. We were worried about our loved ones. School looked different. We were out of church. We couldn't see friends and family as much. And all that can be really scary and nerve-wracking. So I know I'm looking forward to the new year, and I think a lot of other people are too, that we are getting a vaccine for this sickness and that hopefully things will start to take a turn and be a little less scary at times. When I was thinking about the new year, I thought about a verse that we learned way back in September when we were doing the Where in the World is God videos. We did it on every video. We did it every time we got together on Zoom. So let's see, do you still remember it? If so, you can say it with me. Double points if you still remember the hand motions too. Okay, it's Isaiah 43:19. And it says, "See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Can you see it?" Good job. And even if you didn't remember it, that's okay. I remembered it because I really like that verse, because it helps me to remember that God is always doing new things in our lives and in the world. He doesn't have to wait for New Year to come. He does it all the time. And so when I'm feeling uncertain or scared or worried, I like to remember that not only is God always doing new things in my life, but that I can talk to Him about it. I can bring my worries and my fears and my hopes and my dreams, and I can share those with God, and I can ask Him to help me be less afraid or help me feel strong to face what's coming up ahead in my life, or even just talk to Him about what's going on without, you know, worrying about anything else. And He's always there to listen, and He's always there for us. So I like to think about that verse going into the new year as well, that no matter what happens this new year, I'm very hopeful for it, but no matter what happens, God is still there with us, and He's still there to work in my life and work in your life and work in the world in ways we can't even imagine at this point in the year. So I hope that maybe as you're finishing up your holiday celebrations with family, that verse will help you think about what's coming up and think about feeling excited and hopeful for this new year. That's all I have for you guys, so let's say a quick prayer. Dear God, thank you for this new year, and thank you that you're always with us and that you're always doing new things in our lives. Amen. Okay, guys, I gotta go clean up this confetti. Happy New Year!
Earlier this season, I noticed a dear friend of mine, Rob Kaczynski, wrote on Facebook, and he said, "The quintessential, wonderful, theologically sound Christmas carol is O Little Town of Bethlehem." I have such respect for Rob, so I wanted to take a look at it. And remembering that, I thought, that's a great way for us to start this series of Christmas carols. And so as we offer these, I just want you to read the words, sing the message of this series of five different Christmas carols. Some of them will have people singing and you just join, and others will provide just the accompaniment and the lyrics so you can sing from home. Enjoy the story of our faith through the poetry of our hymns as we sing a variety of Christmas carols, beginning with O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Near me, Lord Jesus. dear children in thy tender care, and fit us for heaven to live with thee
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping? This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. Why lies he in such mean estate, where ox and ass are feeding? Good Christian, fear for sinners, hear the silent word, this plea. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold and myrrh, come rich and poor to own him, the King of Kings. Salvation brings, let loving hearts enthrone him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the son of Mary.
As we prepare ourselves for communion, I want to offer everyone an opportunity. Turn to the people who are with you in the room and offer one another signs of peace. May the peace of Christ be with you. Peace of Christ, Brian. Peace of Christ, Joe. And now, join me once again in prayer. Let us pray.
When I pray,
I feel my heart grow deeper, my heart grow deeper into my God when I pray. I feel my heart grow deeper, my heart grow deeper into my God. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. God with us. It is a new year. And we're aware that so many things are new. New possibilities, new beginnings. And yet there are other things on which we rely, things that are perhaps old, traditional anchors for us. We know, O God, we know of the blessing that has come to us through that child in a manger. And we rely on the love that he demonstrated in the world as he moved into the neighborhood then and now. We cling to the assurance, O God, that you are always there for us, always ready to hear the concerns that we hold in our hearts. And today, as we have in the past, today we offer again the names of ones that we love, ones that we lift to you. We pray today for Alan, for Dorothy, for Gary, for Carrie. We pray for granddaughters, Edie and Elise. We pray, O God, for 340,000 families who are grieving over the loss of loved ones who have succumbed to the COVID virus, at least 32 of them in our own county. And even as we pray for those families, we lift up those amongst us, those who are a part of our community who are also fighting the virus. We pray for Tim, we pray for Elaine, we pray for Mary and others. There are those prayer concerns that have been placed into our prayer bowl. Quiet concerns, perhaps a bit more private. And so, O God, we lift all of these prayers, recognizing that this child called Emmanuel offers to us the assurance that you hear our needs, that you share our concerns, that you sit with us. Thank you, Holy One. Amen. Today, as I've mentioned, is Communion Sunday. This past Monday, when we gathered for centering prayer, Jan quoted John Philip Newell. The words were so perfect, and so I have adapted them to the preparation of our communion table today. And so hear these words. God with us, It is because we long for peace that we pray. It is because we hope for wholeness that we hunger. It is because we need forgiveness that we seek new beginnings. And thus, we come to this table, bearing our souls to plead for peace, to summon wholeness, to beg forgiveness of ourselves and one another, and thus, O God, of you, soul within our souls, light within our longings. God with us, long ago when you gathered at table, you took bread. You broke it and you gave it to the disciples and you said, take and eat. This is my body broken for you. And then you took a cup. And when you had given thanks, you gave the cup and you said, drink from this, all of you. This is the cup of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. God with us. As the light from the star baptized the manger, so pour out your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread or crackers, of juice or water. Through the miracle you offer via this technology, may this meal bring us the peace for which we pray, the wholeness for which we hunger, and the forgiveness that grants new beginnings. God with us, hear us as we remember these ancient words. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now I invite you to take your bread as I take this bread. And remember how Jesus broke the bread. You break yours. And he gave it to them. So you go ahead. Take a piece and remember how Jesus said, "This is my body broken for you." And then Jesus took the cup. Go ahead and take your cup and lift it with me and remember how Jesus blessed it. He said, it's the cup of the new covenant poured out for you, for me, for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Take and drink. Prayer after communion comes to us from the Ford Downey family as they sing those words, Dona Nobis Pacem, which means, grant us peace.
Peace.
Here's some opportunities for our family of faith for the coming week. Tomorrow, Centering Prayer will meet at 5 o'clock. On Wednesday, worship and music are going to meet, but we're going to meet via Zoom. We're trying to give ourselves a little bit of space after the holidays, just to keep our distance for a little bit longer. Next Sunday morning, January 10th, our worship service will be virtual again. Again, we feel that that is the safest means of worshiping on these days post-Christmas and New Year's. I want to say a special thank you today for the array of people who helped with our music. I want to say thank you to Joe Ford, to all of the members of our choir. I want to give thanks to Jack Carr and to Belinda, to Jim Ulrich and Evan Ulrich. I want to say thank you to Daniel Ford and David Ford and Karen Downey. And as always, thanks to Brian for all the technology that allows us to come to your home and to offer worship. Hope that you drink in the beauty of our sanctuary. Much of this will disappear by the time we worship again next week. We are into the season of Epiphany. Epiphany is this coming Wednesday. And for us in the church, that means that time when God reveals God's self in the same way that the star shone down on the manger during the season of Epiphany. We kind of think about how Jesus reveals God's way to us, God's way of living. And so we look forward to worship in these next several weeks. Remember that our annual meeting will be on Sunday, January 24th. We anticipate that it will be a hybrid kind of annual meeting in which some people will be here live and others will join us via Zoom. We will not have a live streamed worship service on January 24th, and we'll talk about that more in the next couple of weeks. So, dear friends, it is the second Sunday of Christmas. And so as the Christ candle is lit, it is a reminder again of how the light of Christ entered the neighborhood a long time ago. And when we allow that light to be channeled through us, we invite the Christ into our neighborhood. And so, as you journey into a new year, into a new week, remember how Jesus came. He was called the Prince of Peace. He was called Emmanuel. Now, you don't have to be Jesus. You only have to be the best person that you can be. So go to be the best Sarah you can be. Go to be the best Jim that you can be. Go to be the best David that you can be. Go to be the best person you can be. Live that love. And as I end most often, go to serve God and your neighbor. And go in peace. Amen. And as you go in peace, we leave you now with a little clip from Christmas Eve. There were 46 people who came. We couldn't be outside because, as you'll see, it was teeming rain. But we got a little bit of a video, and the video to me seems such the right ending to the year 2020. Because in the midst of the rain, you hear the beautiful sound of Joe on his saxophone and the promise and the hope encompassed in silent night. Peace, my friends.
Thank you.